about sensors and monitoring, where Javier and my friends will present the results obtained in the Helford Wood and the Optini projects with respect to the personal monitoring systems. Javier is coming from the UPC. He is in charge of the biomedical electric instrument group, and his talk will be on respiratory activity measurements and patients with depression, the Helford Wood approach.
Thank you.
More or less 20 minutes.
Okay, thanks. Well, my name is Javier Rosell, and I will present the work done at the UPC, Universidad Politécnica de Cataluña, together with the Fundación Privada I2CAT, that is mainly involved in the development of the sensor network, the wireless sensor network. Well, when we started the project, it was clear that we had a lot of clinicians in the team, and they said to us, to the engineers, what will be the focus of the project. And it was clear that the system must be for treatment of patients in the community, this means in the normal environment, at work or at home. And that the main things that are tested clinically that we already know that works are the measurements of activity, the sleep quality assessment, and also the speech analysis every day. And one of the things that worries all the people from the beginning was that the sensor must be non-obstructive and non-stigmatizing at all. It means that people could do their normal life without having a mark on them. The virtual agent, that is a complement of the sensor that I will speak in this talk, the objective of that is to engage the patients in a follow-up of physical illness in a day-by-day basis, okay? And improving the adherence to the treatment. Well, from that, as engineers, electronic engineers in my case, and all these colleagues I show in the first slide, we were very amused, and we thought, okay, we could do a lot of things. For example, galvanic skin response, electrocardiography, heart rate variability, and we suggested a lot of things from the literature that could be used in that. But taking into account the opinion of the clinicians and some usability tests that was done a priori, it was clear that the non-obstructive thing and the non-stigmatizing thing were very important. But also, other things came that, for example, it must be cost-effective, and this means that we have to avoid the installation of complicated sensors at homes, at the patient's home, because it costs money, because a technician has to go there, has to put some movement detection, something like that, and this is a high cost. And also the things about privacy. This was important. I will explain to you later some of the ideas that were not implemented at the end for privacy reasons. And another thing that was interesting is that one could think in this segment of 30% that live alone, but we have this 73% or more that live with family. And this means that the sensors must be sensible to only the activity, for example, of the patient, not to the activity of the family. And in some cases also the family must not notice the existence of sensors in the home. And this was another limitation very important in our case. Well, as I said, I will speak about the monitoring system, the sensors. You have here a general diagram of the Helford Wood system. Later you will see other parts of the system, but specifically I will speak about the sensors. From this brainstorming at the beginning of the project, we make intensive bibliographic and commercial analysis of things that are already in the market. It's incredible the number of gadgets for actigraphy that you can find nowadays, and every month it appears a new company selling a new gadget to measure your activity, especially in sports. Okay, and all of you know some examples. For sleep monitoring, was not the same. Sleep monitoring is more difficult. There are very complex systems for sleep analysis and some commercial systems for epilepsy, but not really for sleep quality in depression. And of course, you have all these paraphernalia of gadgets like door sensors, volumetric sensors, RF, ID tags that will be put everywhere, the GPS that you have in the mobile phone, etc., that were investigated. Well, we tested some of these things. We tested a watch. This is the one here in the top that is a commercial device. But the problem is that that is a proprietary system with everything is locked. I mean, there's no access to the raw data. And you have to agree with the company if you want to make some business of that. And we have other things, for example, the EC430, that is a development tool from Texas Instruments that is open source, and you could develop anything with this you could program the microcontroller in any way you want. And have a Wi-Fi connection that is very useful in our case. And of course, we play a lot with the smartphones. In that case, we tested an HTC smartphone and for the sleep monitoring system, as I said, we tested a number of other systems. We don't want that the patient has to wear anything during sleep, or at maximum a watch. And we tested this kind of sensors that are a pad under the mattress. Okay, and this was a good device, but the problem is that it has cables. And if you have to put that in a psychiatric hospital, the cables are forbidden at all. Okay, are forbidden. This means that we had to develop something else without cables. Well, here you have other devices that we didn't test, but they appeared in the market this last year or maybe 2 years ago. And all of them, these activity devices, use accelerometers, usually a 3-axis accelerometer. This means that the raw data is a lot of raw data. You have the acceleration in the 3-axis, and usually at a sampling frequency of 20 Hz, that is enough for the activity of a normal human, normal activity. From that, commercial devices extract a lot of information. Calories, for example. Using some kind of pattern recognition of the activity you are doing, and they detect if you are climbing the stairs or going down, etc., they could make some calculations. In our case, our ambition was to show you. In our case, our objective is to have something that detects an index of activity and track the tendencies during day by day and week by week. Well, in conclusion, we found that the commercial devices were not an obstructive or requires a lot of participation of the person. For example, in downloading data, a lot of the systems in the market, you have to press some button to put the device in a special socket, and you have to recharge the system every one day or 2 days, and this was also not interesting. And we decided at the end to go for the semi-custom device that is the Texas Instruments DC Electronic watch, that is this watch here, that looks like a sports watch. And for the psychiatric people, the clinicians say that it could be okay for at least men. For women, from the beginning, we thought that it would be a problem. And of course, we use also, and we developed some software for smartphones. In the sleep monitoring system, we're not any commercial thing without cables that could be put under the mattress to detect your occupancy of the bed and if you get up or you move a lot or not. We have other alternatives like Doppler radar and volumetric sensors and image sensors, but all of them require a very complex installation at the home. Okay, and I said that we have to avoid that. And for the same reasons, we avoid the other senses you could find in the literature. Well, and then we arrive to the solution you have here, and I have here in hardware. The watch for men and people that want to use a watch. This device, that in fact is the same electronics of this, put in another box, okay, that could be put in your belt, for example, or in your pocket. Or the one that seems that a lot of people is happy with is this one. This is clearly not stigmatizing, because it's a case ring that could be confused by other things, or you could bang it if you want to change the color. And we also developed, as I said, software for the HTC smartphone. Just a bit of electronics, not a lot. This Texas Instrument device is intended for a demonstration of a microcontroller that is this core here, the CC430. Okay? And has also acceleration sensors, this is interesting for us, and a pressure sensor that we are not using. And also, in the case of these boxes, we are not using the screen, we are not using all that. Anyway, you could, if you want to develop something specific for this project, using just the core of the system, that is the CC430. Okay, that is a microcontroller with the RF transmission, receiver transmission and reception. And also it has analog to digital converters that we are using for the sensor in the in the bed. The sensor in the bed looks something like that here. We have a small sensor for bed occupancy and a big sensor that is a piezoelectric sensor that detects small movements on the bed. This means that you could detect when you go to bed and also if you are on bed. And the electronics is put in a corner of this box. And we have the batteries and everything in that small box there. And this could be put under the mattress. In the case of the smartphone, of course, we measure acceleration, but we also wanted to, well, we developed the software for GPS data to know the location of the patient, and also the social interaction, the storing the incoming and outgoing calls to see if the people in the present usually doesn't talk too much to other people and maybe are not using the phone so much. But at the end, this was considered too intrusive for the normal life of the patients, and at the end product is not implemented. Well, as I said, we have these devices all connected with this Texas Instruments Simplicity protocol, that is a low power communications protocol that is connected to this thing, to the smart, well, to the PC, and also we use Bluetooth to connect to the smartphone.